Get ready to match the stars from Shannon Ah, John Bowser Bowman, Red Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Ava Gabor, Artie Johnson, and from Flo, Joyce Beautifont, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Reimer.
Jane, sounds like you got a good group here. A nice, lively bunch, better than the ones we had yesterday, right? Yes, sir?
What happened? What was that? I was talking about my personal life, which is a mess.
Yeah.
And what happened?
Join the two of you?
No.
Nothing. I just did a little funny, and they responded. It's a very responsive group.
That's
if you
lovely.
Do some funnies later in the show,
I
they
hope
will
the director will be kinder to you today than he was last day.
Yes. Did you meet the three Gabors?
Are these the three Gabors?
They're all in blue.
Oh, but Jean, please have Ava stand up and show her dress.
Look yes. How
all right, stand up and show your dress. You must try getting something in blue.
Would you like to see my dress?
You know Hank Hoffman, the sculptor?
Look how upset some people are getting.
Hank Hoffman, our sculptor, Jan Locks, the newlywed lady. All right, are you ready to carry on here? They've played, they're in the second game, aren't they? Oh, yes, it's the second half of round one. And Jan, this is for you. Pete said, Nerdocrumbesia is the world's sleaziest country. At weddings, instead of throwing rice at the bride and groom, they throw blank.
What is it?
What is that country?
Sleazy, sleaziest country. Instead of
darling.
Rice at a wedding, they throw blank.
Darling, I don't want to be stupid, but what the heck is Nerdocrumbesia?
This is a mythical country.
No.
Why did you say so to begin with?
Well, we just wanted to get the idea across that it was a sleazy country.
And then it is a mythological.
Mythological.
I missed that day in school. I haven't a clue.
Well, we didn't want to name any country because we didn't want to hurt anybody's feelings.
The Budapest Elementary School burned down many years ago.
You're from Buda or Pesht?
I am from Pesht.
Okay.
I have to get my answer. I'll be right on, sweetheart.
She's very honest and straightforward about it. When she really gets a mental block, which is quite often, why, she just goes up and says, darling, would you give me an answer, please?
And I got a very good one from Brett.
Good. Brett is a kind soul.
And she's very smart. Oh,
well, right.
Well, Brett is very smart. She's very kind.
Right.
And she loves that blue dress. She looks like a policeman.
Nerdocrumbesia.
Nerdocrumbesia is the world's sleaziest country. At weddings, instead of throwing rice at the bride and groom, they throw blank.
Birth control pills.
That's very creative.
She's newly married. You know where her mind is at.
That's right.
Ava.
Have you got one?
Yeah, I was going to say axle grease, but my hair had solidified, so I couldn't demonstrate. Instead, I changed to rocks.
Rocks. All right.
But I love birth control pills.
Now, for those of you whose children were given little Easter bunnies, real live ones for Christmas, this will strike a note. Rabbit doo-doo.
Right. Tacky, seedy.
Oh, darling.
I said lice.
Lice.
That's funny. That's good, Charlie.
You must have been watching the Shogun all this past week.
No, I didn't watch Shogun.
You did?
Years ago, my mother taught me something.
What'd she teach you?
My mother was funny. She would never look at anything Oriental or with long dresses or English accents.
What?
So we never watched those things.
Here it is, Ava. At weddings, instead of throwing rice at the bride and groom, in this sleazy country, they throw...
Birth control pills was a good answer.
It was very good.
I liked it a lot.
Yes.
But Brett and I said, mainly Brett said stones.
Stones. What did you say, Artie?
I said oatmeal.
Oatmeal. Very good. How about you?
I said cook spaghetti.
Cook spaghetti. Now, one person said garbage. We expected that to happen somewhere along the line. All right, Hank, you're ahead. You have to go first.
A.
A, two people play.
Oh, good, the dummies.
The two.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's us.
Two dummies right here.
The Austro-Hungarian Empire.
Tom said, my new compact car is really small. It has plenty of leg room, but there's no room for my blank.
I can't write what I like to. What are you going to write? Have you got anything? You both read it so funny. Why is it only you and me?
Because everyone else matched in the previous round.
They never said birth control, Pierre.
No, but we're playing with Hank Hoffman now.
Oh, pardon me. We said all together.
You must catch up.
Oh, you know how I am. Well, I'm going to write a square answer.
All right. Hey, Tom said my new compact car is really small. It has plenty of leg room, but there's no room for my blank.
Head.
Head. Little head for Hank.
I can only tell you, Hank and I are going steady because I said head.
Aha! Uh-huh. And you got a little head for Hank. All right. Jan, you know what you have to do. The best you can do is achieve a tie. You can do that by matching all six stars. Here we go. Wally the wise guy said to ugly Ulfria, he said, you're the only person in the world who entered the human race and blanked.
I heard you, but that doesn't mean I know you.
Wally the wise guy said to ugly Ulfria, you're the only person in the world who entered the human race and blanked.
Lost.
Lost. Yeah. Got to match every star here, all six of them.
So far, so good.
So
lost.
Far, so good. All right.
Oh, goodness, I'm lost.
All right. Two for her.
I directed the opera La Traviata recently. You know what that means in English?
La Traviata.
The lost one.
The lost one. Ava, you're the only person in the world who entered the human race and lost.
And lost.
You said it.
Yeah, I'm just crying.
That's four for her. Artie.
Traviata.
Traviata. Joyce.
No. No.
Save it. Yes, so long. All right, we're going to tie score here 6-6. We'll break the tie later. Now this for you. Now we go to the tiebreaker. Turn these lights off. Push the button. One question for each. The one who matches the most will be the winner. Hank, what do you say? A or B?
A.
A. No. Okay, Hank. Carl the cannibal got fired.
I'll tell
you why he got fired, because he ate his blank during lunch hour. Carl the cannibal. Let's go, Abe. Carl the cannibal got fired because he ate his blank during lunch hour.
He ate his guest.
He ate his guest.
Yes.
Give me
guest is not bad.
It's not good either.
Ready?
No. Hey, it's boss.
What did Hank say?
Guest.
Oh, guest. I thought he said desk. I thought that's what it was.
Maybe it's Hungarian guest for boss.
Employer.
Employer. Boss is what we're getting so far here. What do you say, sir?
Secretary.
Secretary. Very good. Ava?
Well, I am with Charles. I said wife.
Wife.
That's all right.
That's Hungarian for boss.
Yes.
Wife.
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 Vice.
The boss was the wife.
The boss, wife.
All right, Joyce.
I also said boss.
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 Got a lot of bosses there, Hank.
Boss.
But we got no guests. Jan, all you need to do is match one to win. When Henry opened his fortune cookie, it said, you will meet a woman with long, dark hair.
How dark?
How long are you going to meet her?
How long, how dark?
You will meet a woman with long, dark hair. Unfortunately, it'll be on her blank.
Hey,
we go.
Oh, no.
When Henry opened his fortune cookie, it said, you will meet a woman with long, dark hair. Unfortunately, it'll be on her blank.
On her chest.
Chest. All right. One chest will win the game, John.
Do I get to hug her again, or are we short on time?
No, you can't hug her.
Ah! Well, I matched anyway.
Chest wins the game. What the rest of them? Hold them up. Hank, what do we got for Hank? What kind of prize is it? What can we get, Hank? How about it? All right, on the escort. No, we're going to send you a bucket full of chicken lips. You're going to love them, Hank. It's a pleasure to meet a sculptor. Good luck to you, Hank Hoffman. Here you go again. Now, Jan, we polled the studio audience, said write down your best answer to this. Brisk blank. Remember, it's 500 for the most popular, 250 for the second most popular, and 100 for the third. And let's see what sort of assistance you get this time.
Bowser.
I put brisk walk.
A brisk walk, right?
Choice?
A brisk day.
Brisk day.
I have a better one for that. I can't change it now, can I?
Charles?
No.
This is what it should be.
Well, give it to him.
Here it comes.
I know. I'm just trying to get my breath. I'm older now. It takes me a minute. I want you to snap into it. I think a very good thing to think about would be brisk weather.
Good.
Brisk weather, brisk day, and a brisk walk. You want one of those or one of your own?
That's good.
The first thing I thought of was brisk walk.
A brisk walk. All right. That's John Bowser's answer. Let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 response? Brisk tea.
Oh, indeed.
Now, the next one says brisk wind.
Oh.
All right. Not yet, John. I'll tell you when, okay?
I know we're short of time, so I got to be ready.
All right. Go. All right. Did he hurt you with those chains? Get back there.
Just don't unroll my pants, please.
Yeah. You know, isn't if they should get married, there'd be locks and chains.
Right.
You know what? Her husband was in the front row yesterday.
Locks and chains.
That's
locks
very good. Chains. Better than bagels.
All right. Now, $500 means you're going to play for $5,000 again. However, we want you to spin the wheel and see if you can double it up and play for $10,000. So step up there and have a go at it, and we'll root for a double. Close. All right, you're playing for $5,000. Good luck to you. Here we go, Chuck. An honest blank. Charles is ready, Jan. If you give us the answer that he has in the card, you get $5,000. What do you say to that?
An honest dollar.
An honest dollar.
Yeah.
All right, Charles, let's find out if...
I'm sorry, I said face.
An honest face.
I'm sorry.
I would have written an honest man. An honest
That's
buck,
tall.
An honest man,
dollar.
Honest face and all that.
Work.
How much does she have altogether? $1,000. That's not bad. I hope you can use that in your newly made life. Thank you, Jan. Bye. Spin a little message for you and meet two new players in just about 1 minute. Thank you. Let's welcome Susan McCartney and Rhonda Brooker. Hey! Hello there, ladies. Welcome to the both of you. Remember, you'll be playing two games. Let's get acquainted. Susan, tell us about you, please.
I'm a freelance secretary from Laguna Beach, California. And in my free time, a lot of art festival people out there, in my free time, I'm very active in the ballet and in the community theater in my area.
That sounds like you've got a good, full, rich life, Susan. Good luck here. Rhonda, tell us about you.
Okay, I'm 19, and I'm a sophomore at USC. I'm from San Jose, California, and I'm single, but not unattached.
You're beautiful.
Thank you.
All right, ladies, let's go. Susan, you want A or B?
B, please.
B it is for her.
And the pretty both of them, they love
it. Yes, they're beautiful. Frank said, today I got good news and bad news. The good news is my kid gave me a wallet. The bad news is he made it out of the blank.
Okay, I got you.
Thanks. He's very easy.
That guy is a terrific name. Let's call him.
Here we go. Frank said today I got good news and bad news. The good news is my kid gave me a wallet. The bad news is he made it out of the blank.
The money.
Out of the money?
You can't spend it.
Out of what? Out of money.
The money.
Oh, come on.
Money is her response. Not a winning answer, I would
think. Don't take it personally, Susan. Sticks and stones can break your bones, but booze can never hurt you. Oh, I put couch.
Leather couch. Yeah. Out of a leather couch.
I was
going
to say cow, but you don't usually have one in the house.
I have a feeling this is not going to be the most popular answer ever given on this show. But after all, I haven't been well. Made it out of the new baby.
Oh! Oh! Really?
Oh, it's the first time I've laughed this week. It feels good.
Shades of Ava Brown. Yes?
I think Bess Meyerson lives in New York.
Yes, she does.
Flying around.
Right.
She's a lovely person. Dog.
Dog is good.
That's a Betty White egg.
Yeah, we were looking for dog and cat here, Ava. Good news is a kid, bad news is made it out of the what?
Out of my best shoe.
Best shoe. All right, there's a piece of leather. That'd be a good response, yes.
Separa zuva karma.
Out of a cordy now. Out of a carta.
What did you say?
The poor family conversation.
It's true, you're right.
Cat.
I'm the black sheep of the Gabor family.
All right, Ronnie, let's see what we have for you here. Marty said, my wife is the world's worst cook. Last night, I almost choked on a bone in the blank. You must pay more attention.
How are you going to be quiet?
Oh, I see. Okay.
I see.
Good for you, my dear.
Oh gosh, I can't even cut it.
Katie, great name.
Very dumb.
Now, Ron. Marty said my wife is the world's worst cook. Last night, I almost choked on a bone in the blank.
Casserole?
In the casserole.
No.
I think we're going to end up with a real matched pair here.
All right,
John. She said casserole.
She said casserole. I said coffee.
In the coffee. That would be an unlikely place to find a bone.
Well, actually, I didn't say either of those answers. I said consommé.
Consommé, another good response.
I didn't have a governess. So
I did.
Say all that. I said Jell-O.
Jell-O is very good. All good up there. Excellent. World's worst cook. Last night I was choked on a bone in the...
Scrambled eggs.
Scrambled eggs. All right, Artie.
Mashed potatoes.
Aha! Very good.
Bread pudding.
I love that.
Bread pudding. Well, I was right. It's a matched pair, isn't it? Zip to zip the score here. And a round one, round two coming up later. Now this. Well, time flies, doesn't it?
When you're having fun.
Yes.
It's time to go. Yourself?
It's time to go now. Listen, anybody have anything they'd like to contribute here?
No, I'd just like to sum up the director in one word.
I must come to his defense. He's really a very sweet and thoughtful fellow.
Oh, are you kidding?
Are you kidding? The mind.
That's not Rose.
Why are you so mad at him? He's very nice. Why are you so mad at him?
Well, he's mad at him.
Why
not
mad at him, Charles?
Look at this. No, because he
insulted. Tune in tomorrow. Find out if the ongoing saga between Charles and the director is a continuing situation or whether it is rectified.
You wear this shoe?
Whether the director will win or Charles. Which one has the most power or schmaltz, as they say?
Yeah. Well, this is really the end.
Weirdest week I've ever spent
to the bottom of the pit. Join us next time.
So much fun with
everybody talking at one time here. It's wonderful. Say a few words here.
I don't believe this.
I'm Gene Rayburn. Good. Bye.
Thank you.
contestants will receive a Betty Crocker cookbook and Make Someone Happy with Snack and Cake. The cake with a snack inside, like walnuts, raisins, or chocolate chips. There's a snack inside every snack and cake. And two towels and cat-free foaming bath oil provides a relaxing bouquet for your bath, leaving your skin soft and smooth, your bathtub clean. Cat-free, more of a beautiful thing for less. And a juice set and three top, America's favorite frozen apple juice, 100% pure juice, no artificial ingredients, and no sugar added. And a baking dish and cream mess, the macaroni and spaghetti in the famous green box, cooks up tender without sticking together. And a gravy bowl with ladle and kitchen bouquet for better homemade gravy. When you add kitchen bouquet, you add 100 years experience in making homemade gravies look and taste more delicious. And Baker's Secret from Echo, the silicone-coated non-stick bakeware is the easy way to better baking. Makes cleanup easy as pie. And a calculator and pledge gives your furniture a clean, clear, and more beautiful shine. Pledge brings out the beauty every time you dust.